The answer to the question, just in case you were wondering. It's tricky to rock a rhyme. To rock a rhyme, that's right, on time, it's tricky. There you go. Just in case you were wondering. Okay, so what do we have left? Well, what about this situation? I get a negative 25 in decimal. How do I represent a negative number in binary? And this was a problem that they had to solve as they were, you know, going through the process, inventing computers and working with all this stuff. How do you represent a negative number? And what they decided eventually was that they would take the first number. So let's say we have four numbers. They said, let's take the first number and, well, there's a few different ways they do it. By the way, this is just one of the ways, but this is the way that is currently done that we talk about. They said, let's take that number and make this represent whether it's holding a positive or a negative number. So if the number's zero, that means it's a positive number. And if the number is a one, this first leftmost digit, that means it's a negative number. Okay, but the interesting thing about it is, what did that do to our number of options? Now, how do we calculate? If I have a combination lock, have any of you ever tried to break into a combination lock, and it's got four numbers on the combination lock, how many different combinations are there? Well, you might say there's 9,999, but that's not true. There are actually 10,000 because 0000 is one of the combinations. So it's going to be one more than the 9999. The way we actually figured out, the easier way, and the way you'll want to do it, is to say how many digits are there. So in this case, there's four, or other way around. What base are we in? So in this case, we're in base 10, and then how many digits are there? There's four. 10 to the 4 is going to be 10,000 different combinations. So in this case, I had 4 bits, and we were in binary. So 2 to the 4 tells me that I can represent 16 different things. And if I wanted to go through and list them out, I could. We start with 0000. Then we go to 0001, 0002. 0003, and so on and so forth. Whoa. That's funny. That's autopilot, and it is too dang late in the day to start this video over. So we are going forward, full speed ahead. So let's try that again. We got 0001, 0010, 0011, 00, 01, 0, 1, 0, and so on and so forth. We would get all the way up to 16 to have those different numbers of combinations. Okay, so when we reserve one of the bits to represent whether it's positive or negative, now we can only represent 2 to the 3 things, which is going to be 8. Okay, we take this first digit and use it to say, is that a positive or a negative number? But, so probably initially, that's how we just did it. We just said, if it's a number like negative 25, let's decide what the positive value is and then add a 1 at the beginning if it's a negative. But there was this method that somebody came up with that's pretty ingenious, actually, called 2's complement. Okay, so in 2's complement, we represent negative numbers we still use the first bit to represent the number, but we go through kind of a process to convert a number into a negative number using 2's complement, which is what we use. So if I take a number again like negative 25 and say that's in base 10, and I want to know what that is in base 2. How do I represent that? Well, what I do first is figure out what's the positive value. So I say these are the 1s, 2s, 4s, 8s, 16s, and I know I don't need 32 because 32 is too big. So 16, I say I have 1 16. Can I get an 8 in there too? Yeah, that'll take me to 24. Okay, and then all I have left is a 1 to get to 25. Okay, so that's a 25 in binary. Okay, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1. All right. So then in order to change it to a 2's complement number, the first thing I need to do, and this is critically important, is extend my zeros to the length of the bus. Now, getting back to our architecture chapter, a bus, let's say, is 32 bits. If there isn't an electrical signal on that line, then it's going to be counted as a zero. And in order for this math to work, we need to extend those zeros to the length of the bus. And so in our case, when I'm messing around with this, I'm just going to assume we have a 16-bit bus rather than a 32-bit bus or a 64-bit bus to be able to pass this information along. And so what that means is I need to have 16 digits in total. So let me write this number again over here like this. 1, 1, 0, 0, 1. Okay, I need to extend this out to 16 bits. And again, if I have a number like 25 positive and I add a 0 on the front, that doesn't change the fact that it's a 25. I can add as many zeros as I want to out here, and mathematically nothing changes. Okay, whereas if I add a number on this side, then I'm really changing the value of that number, and the more zeros I add, the more that value changes. So here I can add as many zeros as I want to out here. So I've got to have 16 this out to 16 bits. Once I do that, what I do is flip the bits. Okay, so I change everything that's a 0 to a 1 and everything that's a 1 to a 0. So I reverse the bits. So this becomes a 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. Okay, and then I add 1. We're going to be getting real close to the bottom. Oh, I can do my thing that I accidentally do sometimes. Whoop, there we go. So I add 1 to this, and the math works just like in decimal. So 1 plus 0 is 1. Don't push the button now, Spencer. 1 plus 0 is 1. 1, 0. Everything's just going to come down. And this is my answer. This is a negative 25 stored using 2's complement protocol. Okay, that's a negative 25. So the steps are, number one, convert to the positive equivalent. So we had a 25, so I converted to a positive 25 first, right here. The second step then is to extend to the length of the bus. What does that say? That's just sorry, even for a little pen board. Length of the bus. Flip the bits. And step four is to add 1 to the result. Convert to the positive, extend to the length of the bus, flip the bits, and add 1. Now, in the next video, I will show... There we go. In the next video, I will show you why we do that. Stay tuned. Spencer out.